Jamie, when you and I were at spring training, the coaching staff was very impressed with this young man to my right, left-hander, 10 days. And congratulations, you're here in the show. You know, manager John Gibbons tells the media that when he calls these young guys up, he likes to just throw them in the fire, get them out there day one. Was it your time last night? Do you think, in retrospect, that was better for you? You had 24 hours to really kind of let everything sink in and get your thoughts together? Or would you have preferred to go right in there and get all those butterflies out?
I don't know if I really have a preference. You know, it's kind of whatever wants to get me out there. I think it's my job to be ready and my job to go out there and compete to the best of my ability whenever my name gets me.
You know, there was so much talk, as I said, in spring training of how much promise you had. And I understand a former Cy Young Award winner and now special assistant for this organization paid you a visit when you were in high identity. Pat Henkin paid you a visit. What happened and what did you take away from what Henkin did?
Well, Pat kind of has been traveling, you know, to each of the affiliates, so I've been able to speak with him numerous times. It was great advice, you know. One of the things that I was able to take away from him was to, you know, get ahead and get out of it, which means get ahead of hitters and expand, and I took that, and that's kind of what I like to, you know.
You talk about maybe resembling a particular pitcher.
I don't know. I've always kind of had somewhat of a comparison to Brett Cecil, is what people say.
That's pretty good.
Like panics and stuff, but I don't know if there's one guy that I try to resemble my game after. I take bits and pieces of guys who have success and try to incorporate that into my game.
What do you think has been the biggest improvement in your career? You know you've got this talent. You know you got to tweak and make adjustments if you want to get to this level. What do you think is the biggest improvement?
I think what every pitcher strives for, that's great fastball command. Having great fastball command is usually the key to success for pitchers. Me personally, I like to command my slider. I think that's been kind of a big improvement over the years. Was not only continuing to work on fastball command, but being able to sharpen up my slider and locate it wherever and whatever.
How were you used, Tim, in Buffalo? Were you a lefty specialist? Did you pitch multiple innings? How were you used with the Bisons? And are you able to tell manager John plans on using it here?
You're welcome.
In Buffalo, it was as news, next man up. So whoever had the most rest, you knew you were getting in there. And it was your job to be ready to go multiple innings or to be able to go one inning or a couple innings here and there. It's just, like I said, whenever your name gets called, it's your job to go out there. And whenever the manager takes the ball from you, then your night's done. So you just have to be prepared for anything, really.
Is there a big jump from AA to AAA?
In terms of hitters, probably not. But I think, you know, when I got to AAA, it was more of a tweaking my own game. And I think I was able to sharpen things up over the past 6 months.
That's your family still here. I saw you last night with them taking pictures in the Congress. Are they here still?
Yes.
They're not going to miss it if you're going to be out there making a debut tonight.
No, I'm sure they won't.
Tim Mason, congratulations once again. Great to talk to you, and good luck.
Thanks for having me.
All right, Tim Mason, Jamie, let's get back to you.